The Holy Gospel according to St. John. Glory be to thee, O Lord. Chapter 2. And the third day there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. And Jesus also was invited and his disciples to the marriage. And the wine failing, the mother of Jesus saith to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus saith to her, "Woman, what is that to me and to thee? My hour is not yet come." His mother saith to the waiters, "Whatsoever he shall say to you, do ye." Now there were set there 6 water pots of stone, according to the manner of the purifying of the Jews, containing 2 or 3 measures apiece. Jesus saith to them, "Fill the water pots with water," and they filled them up to the brim. And Jesus saith to them, "Draw out now, and carry to the chief steward of the feast." And they carried it. And when the chief steward had tasted the water made wine, he knew not whence it was. But the waiters knew who had drawn the water. The chief steward calleth the bridegroom, and saith to him, "Every man at first setteth forth good wine, and when men have well drunk, then that which is worse. But thou hast kept the good wine until now." This beginning of miracles did Jesus in Cana of Galilee, and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him. After this he went down to Capernaum, he and his mother and his brethren and his disciples, and they remained there not many days. And the Pasch of the Jews was at hand, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. And he found in the temple them that sold oxen and sheep and doves, and the changers of money sitting. And when he had made, as it were, a scourge of little cords, he drove them all out of the temple, the sheep also and the oxen, and the money of the changers he poured out, and the tables he overthrew. And to them that sold doves he said, "Take these things hence, and make not the house of my Father a house of traffic." And his disciples remembered that it was written, "The zeal of thy house hath eaten me up." The Jews therefore answered and said to him, "What sign dost thou show unto us, seeing thou dost these things?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews then said, 46 years was this temple in building, and wilt thou raise it in 3 days? But he spoke of the temple of his body. When therefore he was risen again from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the word that Jesus had said. Now, when he was at Jerusalem at the Pasch, upon the festival day, many believed in his name, seeing his signs which he did. But Jesus did not trust himself unto them, for that he knew all men, and because he needed not that any should give testimony of man, for he knew what was in man. Thus far are the words of the gospel. Praise be to thee, O Christ. I apologize for the errors I made in reading. I have a head cold. That's why my voice is a little bit off. I'm all nasally, and my eyes are a little watery. I apologize. Just a few comments on the second chapter of John's gospel. It begins on the third day, which of course reminds us of Christ rising on the third day. But if you look at chapter 1, there's actually 4 days in chapter 1. So this would bring us to the 7th day. If you go back to chapter 1, it says, "And the next day, and the next day, and on the following day." And then that would bring us to this third day, which brings us to a 7th day, a Sabbath. So this wedding supper is the eschatological end time supper. It also happens to be our Lord's first miracle, the changing of water into wine. For Catholics, this is important because it shows that the first miracle of Christ, our Lord, was mediated. It was instrumentalized by the mother of Jesus. We see that Jesus, they say they have no wine. And so then Our Lady goes to Our Lord and says, they have no wine. And Our Lord says something curious. He says, woman, what is that to me and to thee? That's literally what it says in the original. What is that to me and to thee? Seems that Our Lord is connecting himself and her. He's also calling her woman, which is the word, the first name that Adam gave to Eve. And we Catholics believe that Mary is the new Eve. He says, my hour is not yet come. So even though it's the third day, Christ is saying this is just the beginning of his ministry. Of course, if Christ can turn water into wine, he can turn wine into his blood. That is the miracle of the Holy Eucharist. We also see that in verse 12, our Lord travels with his mother. So she is from the beginning kind of part of his ministry, and she is the first disciple of Christ. And then in the second half of chapter 2, we see Christ creating a scourge of little cords and driving the money changers and the animals out of the temple. And his response to them is, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. So again, we have 3 days mentioned in this chapter. And he says in verse 21, he's speaking of the temple of his body. So we Catholics believe that the temple of God, the eschatological temple, the real temple of true worship, is the body of Christ. It's not a building in Jerusalem. It is the true body of Christ, which we receive in the holy sacrifice of the Mass. That's why also later on in John chapter 6, he'll talk about how we access this new temple, which is his body, and that is by eating his flesh and drinking his blood. And then one more observation at the very end, verse 24, but Jesus did not trust himself unto them, for he knew all men. This right here tells us that Christ is not confused about who he is. This is something that heretics in our time teach, that Christ didn't know who he was. He kind of came unto himself, or he had an existential crisis in which he began to realize that he was the Son of God. No, Christ knew he was the Son of God from the very first moment he entered the womb of the Immaculate Virgin Mary, and he knew all men. He already knew the thoughts of all men. Verse 25, for he knew what was in man. So here we see that Christ can work miracles like God. Christ is the temple of God. And then Christ is also the judge of all men. He's omniscient. He knows all things. Well, thanks for watching. And I'll come back with John chapter 3, and we'll continue to move through the gospel of St. John. And we'll close with a prayer. Oremus. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, or pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. All right. Thanks so much for watching. Please pray for me. I'll pray for you. Till next time, God bless and Godspeed.